Very good morning. I am Rajiv Kumar, Associate Professor in Department of Physics, SKIT and MG, Jaipur. And topic of discussion, Maxwell Equation in Electromagnetism, Lecture 2. In first lecture, we discussed Maxwell first and second equation. And today's lecture, we discussed Maxwell third and fourth equation. Maxwell's third equation based on Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, EMI. As we know, Faraday's law states that as long as magnetic flux linked with closed circuit chains, an EMF is induced. So, magnitude of EMF is always equal to rate of change of magnetic flux. So, this term represents magnetic flux. Del over del t change with time equal to EMF. This small e stand for EMF. EMF electromotive force. This term is some sort of similar as potential difference. A negative sign. Negative sign due to Lenz law. The direction of induced EMF such that it opposes the change in magnetic flux. Now, EMF is basically meaning the amount of work done to move a unit charge once around a complete circuit. Unit charge ko external circuit mein battery ke point A se B tak le jane mein aur battery ke andar B se A tak lane mein jo work done karna padega. This work done is actually EMF, electromotive force. Unit is same as potential difference, volt. So EMF we write down line integral of electric field over a closed path. This stands for EMF. Small e EMF and capital E for electric field. Now value of EMF from equation number 6 we put in equation number 5. So equation number 5 become this equal to right hand side this. As we know, two operation, differentiation and integral, both are independent. So we exchange these two terms. Integral bahar aayega and del over del t yaha aayega. So we write down this expression like that. Integral over del b over del t dot d. So this expression is called integral form of Maxwell's third equation. Now we apply Stokes and curl theorem. This theorem actually convert line integral into surface or surface integral into line. So this left hand side we replace by surface integral term. So equation number 7 become del cross E dot dA or surface integral equal to this term. So as both side surface integral, so we write down del cross E same as minus del B over del T. And this is called differential form of Maxwell's third equation. For static field, when magnetic field does not change with time, del cross E become zero. Now we discuss Maxwell's fourth equation. Maxwell's fourth equation based on Ampere's circuitial law. As we already know, Ampere's circuitial law states that line integral of magnetic field around any closed path is equal to the product of mu naught times sum of the current passing through the closed loop. So, line integral of magnetic field over a closed path equal to mu naught times the total current passes through the closed path. So this is summation over total I which passes through closed path. And total current you can write down in terms of current density. So current density we call current per unit area. The current per unit cross section area. So if current is passes along this direction, so current per unit cross section area, this is cross section area, is called the current density. So total current in terms of current density integral over surface J dot dA. J current density and dA the area element. This is a small area element. This integral is open integral. This is not a closed integral. So this is an open surface. Now put value of sum over I in equation number 9. So equation number 9 become this side same mu naught times and total current in terms of J. This is called integral form. Now similar we use Stokes and Curl theorem. Remember Maxwell third and fourth equation we will use Stokes and Curl theorem. So we convert line integral into surface integral. So left hand side of equation number 10 replaced by this term. So we write down integral over surface del cross B dot dA equal to mu naught times this term. यहाँ कोई सर्किल नहीं है, यह इंटीग्रल क्लोज सरफेस पर नहीं है, because this represent an open surface, nearly a circular surface. So both side surface integral. So this expression we write down del cross B equal to mu naught J. This is called differential form. So del cross B equal to mu naught J. This relation is called Ampere's law. But Ampere's law is hold good only for static field, the field which does not change with time. The problem occur when we consider time varying field. So equation number 11, taking both side divergence of equation number 11, this become del dot del cross B, divergence means del dot, equal to mu naught times del dot J. Mu naught is constant. Vector identity divergence of curl B. So divergence of curl B equal to 0. Remember this expression. So when this term is 0, left hand side becomes 0, so right hand side is also 0. This will give you del dot J equal to 0. Now we use continuity equation. This is a general equation for static and time varying field. Del dot J plus del rho by del t equal to 0. J for current density, rho for volume charge density. When we compare equation number 13 and 14, this term is 0, so del rho by del t also becomes 0. This implies rho equal to constant. Rho constant means rho does not change with time. So this relation shows that rho constant means equation number 11 only hold for static field which does not change with time. Now what happens when we use time varying? This equation does not explain the current varying, explain when the time varying current passes between two plates of capacitor. It means we use a simple circuit, a battery, a capacitor, a resistance, a galvanometer and switch. As you already know, what's happened when switch at the instant, at a particular instant, when switch is on and off, at this particular instant of time, galvanometer show deflection. Means, jab switch on hoga, ऑफ होगा उस पर्टिकुलर टाइम पर इस सर्किट में एक करंट फ्लो होती है इंस्टेंट करंट. बट वी नो फॉर करंट सर्किट इज ऑलवेज क्लोज फॉर ए करंट. करंट इज ऑलवेज पासिस इन क्लोज सर्किट. तो यहां से लेकर यहां तक तो कंडक्टिंग वायर है, यहां से लेकर यहां तक कंडक्टिंग वायर है. करंट पासिस ड्यू टू फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन, इसे हम बोलते हैं जेसी, द कंडक्शन पार्ट, द करंट ड्यू टू फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन. बट कैपेसिटर की दो प्लेट के बीच में एयर है, वैक्यूम है, तो करंट कहां से पास होगी? सो हाउ वी कैन एक्सप्लेन द करंट पासिस बिटवीन टू प्लेट ऑफ कैपेसिटर? मैक्सवेल एक्सप्लेन द करंट विच पासिस बिटवीन टू प्लेट ऑफ कैपेसिटर. द करंट फ्लो इन वैक्यूम एंड दिस करंट इज कॉल्ड डिस्प्लेसमेंट करंट. एज नाउ मैक्सवेल थॉट एज अकॉर्डिंग टू फैराडेज लॉ चेंज इन मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स इंड्यूस्ड करंट. सिमिलर चेंज इन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑल्सो इंड्यूस्ड करंट एंड दिस करंट पासिस बिटवीन टू प्लेट ऑफ कैपेसिटर. सो मैक्सवेल मॉडिफाइड एम्पियर लॉ and this also introduced the concept of displacement current. According to Maxwell, at a time of switch on or off, charge reside at these two plate of capacitors change with time. If charge change with time, the electric field between two plate change with time, and this change in electric fields also induced current. So he replaced total current density equal to JC plus JD. JC, the current density due to free electron because of conduction. JD due to displacement. So, del dot J, equation number 13, we write down 13 number del dot J. So, with J replaced by two terms, JC plus JD. So, when we put this term in 13 equation, del dot JC plus JD equal to zero. Now equation number 14 we write down as this term, the equation of continuity. So del dot J replaced by JC, only conduction part, plus del dot by del T equal to zero. Now we compare these two equation. So del dot JC replaced by this term. Del dot JC minus del dot JD plus del dot by del T equal to 0. So del dot JD equal to del dot by del T. Now there are two terms, one due to free electron, one due to change in electric field. And this change in electric field induces displacement current. Now, as we know from Maxwell's first equation, we discussed in last lecture, del dot D equal to rho. So we put this expression in equation number 17. So we rho replaced by del dot D. So put del dot D in equation number 17. So del dot JD equal to del over del T, del dot D equal to 0. Same, del operator and del over del T both are independent. So we interchange these two. Del dot JD equal to del dot del D by del T. So JD become del D by del T. Equation number 18. Now we put equation number 18 in equation number 11, which is del cross B equal to mu naught J, the differential form of Ampere's law. So now J replaced by JC plus JD. So del cross B mu naught JC plus JD replaced by del D over del T. Del cross B, mu naught time J, mu naught time D is epsilon naught E, so epsilon naught E. You can check JD term. As long as electric field change with time, this term hold and this term represent displacement. So, jab tak electric field change hoga, capacitor ki plate ke beech mein current flow hoga, jaise hi electric field constant ho gaya, कोई करंट फ्लो नहीं होगा. मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ बोथ द कंडक्शन पार्ट एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट पार्ट ऑलवेज रिमेन सेम, बट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ जे डी इज ड्यू टू चेंज इन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. द करंट विच फ्लो इन वैक्यूम ड्यू टू चेंज इन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज कॉल्ड डिस्प्लेसमेंट करंट. सो मैक्सवेल मॉडिफाई एम्पियर्स लॉ, सो इट्स एक्सप्लेन बोथ फॉर स्टेटिक एंड मैग्नेटिक field or time varying field. So this relation is called modified Ampere's law or differential form of Maxwell's fourth equation. So thanks for today.